that from your infinite resources
in heaven that you came to this earth and that you give into us all that you are, all that we need, all that you have. Thank you that for this awareness that your ways are higher than our ways, our thoughts, your thoughts higher than our thoughts. And so Jesus, this morning we're opening our hearts to say, change us into your thinking like you think, Lord Jesus, into seeing your perspectives here on earth and how your kingdom moves forward so that we can be on mission with you and stepping along with you in it. Lord Jesus, you make holy this physical world because even though it's fallen, you are here among it and you reclaim it for your glory. And so, Lord God, as we give to you this morning, we do it to give it into the beauty of your holiness and for it to be used to be bringing about the splendor of your majesty, your redeemed community here among us on earth as is in heaven, Lord God. As it's used to be for us, this body that represents you, for us, this ministering body that serves in the way that you serve, Jesus. We ask that you would be honored with it, that you would bless each person that gives, that you would just pour upon us a spirit of generosity, a spirit of testimony, of sacrificial love that extends out of every aspect of our life, because Jesus, that's what you did, and we want to be like you. And so to that end, we pray, and we ask now that as we move into the message, that you would have your blessing upon your word this morning and upon the brother that delivers it to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Pastor Gishu, would you join me up here this morning as I just give you a word of introduction and get a mic for you here. You're part of a special club that forms in my mind. I keep track of people that I'm with on different continents of the world. And so I first got to know Pastor Gishu when I was visiting as a guest of the Meseritas Christos Church in Ethiopia. The Meseritas Christos Church is a church of 800,000 people across the country of Ethiopia and in neighboring countries. They began by LMC and EMM missions, sending missionaries there 75 years ago. And out of those small beginnings, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and with suffering and persecution and much like that, the Holy Spirit has blessed the church, and they are thriving and growing, and it's a blessing to be partnering with them. And so this morning, Pastor Gishu is the president of their seminary. Last week or 2 weeks ago, you had a graduation.
The
20th of May, and you graduated how many students?
101
students. Okay. This is a church movement that talks like, you know, we have 1,000 and some churches and we have 900 and some church plantings. And so they need lots of leaders, right? And so Pastor Gishu, it is an honor to have you here this morning.
Thank you.
And to hear from the word of God from you this morning as you minister to us.
Thank you.
Greetings from Ethiopia and my church, Meseritas Christos Church and the seminary. Today is such an honor to share the word of God among you. And I have been in ministry for such a long time. And I have a lot of experience, which I'm not going to tell you this morning, but I would like to read from Acts chapter 1 from verse 1 through 8. That's my text for this morning. So I'm going to read Acts chapter 1, verse 1 through 8. The former account I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after he through the Holy Spirit had given commandment to the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom he also presented himself alive after his suffering by many infallible proofs, being seen by them during 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, "You have heard from me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, "Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel?" And he said to them, "It is not for you to know times or seasons which the Father has put in his own authority." "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." There is a minister in Ethiopia. He leads a congregation. We have known each other for some time. I once asked him, "How did you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior?" Then he began telling me a very brief story. He says, "Once I was traveling together with you by bus, in which you were preaching the gospel. After listening to your preaching, I decided to follow Jesus Christ." That's what he said. I did not know this before he told me. I read from Acts chapter 1, verses 1 through 8. And you read the commandments Jesus gave to his apostles and the answer he gave to their questions. Commandments and question and answer. The book of Acts, it tells of the founding of Christian church and the spread of its message to the Roman Empire. My emphasis is on the message that spread to the Roman Empire, to the whole globe, in fact. So it's obvious, and I hope everyone knows that the book of Acts was written by Luke, the one who wrote the Gospel of Luke. In this text, verses 1 through 8, the discussion was, according to Luke, or the talk was between Jesus Christ, the one who was about to ascend, and his chosen apostles. Remember? He had trained them for such a long time, minimum of 3 years. The training was so wonderful. It's amazing, it might be unique, because it was Christ who trained them. The training was not only about theory, but it was so practical. They heard from him, they learned from him, and as they saw him preaching, healing, casting out demons, raising dead, and a lot of miracles, wonders, and power manifestation. They saw him preaching, doing a lot of miracles, wonders, and power manifestation. The training was so unique. I don't know if any institution, including our institution, that can train in the same way that Christ did. It was so unique. They were trained in such unique way, well trained, well versed, full of knowledge of the kingdom of God, and they know Jesus Christ personally. A lot of things that makes them unique. The training was so unique, well trained. But remember, Jesus commanded them in Matthew chapter 28, verses 19, go. But this time, according to Luke, he commanded them not to leave Jerusalem. Go, not to leave Jerusalem. Go or don't go. You know, the time was when Jesus Christ was ready to ascend. And it was also the time to assign witnesses. There must be a trained apostles that he should leave behind before his ascension. It was not strange. I mean, Jesus was ready for that because he had been training them for such a long time. And now it is time for him to ascend, but with trained apostles leaving behind. But the very, he said, but if though he trained them for such a long time, but he said, don't leave Jerusalem. Don't go. He wanted them to be his witnesses, but with preconditions. No, it's not preconditions, just precondition, just a condition, just a precondition. They had been trained very well, as I said earlier, but that was not enough. That was not enough. Even though they were trained by Jesus himself, theoretically and practically, with a lot of things that made them unique, but still, he says, don't go. There is a precondition to be met. When the Holy Spirit has come upon you, you will receive the power of the Holy Spirit, he says. And you have to, he says, you have to receive the power of the Holy Spirit before leaving Jerusalem. I believe in education. That's why we have seminary. Our seminary graduated about 2,273 graduates. We believe in education. We believe in human wisdom, skill, and other things. Jesus believed in training and other things. You know, that is why he took such a long time to train his apostles, minimum of 3 years. He believes in training, in education, in human wisdom, and other things, a lot of stuff. Still, if he is around, he would say, that is not enough. That is not enough. You need, he says to the apostles, you need to be baptized by the Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters, we all are called into ministry to continue the ministry of Jesus Christ. Notice the word that I am using, to continue the ministry of Jesus. We are called to continue the ministry of Jesus Christ. We don't have our own ministry. There is no such a thing like our ministry. We don't have our ministry. We are called, we are here to continue the ministry of Jesus Christ. It's to act on behalf of Jesus Christ. That is the topic of my message. Acting on behalf of Jesus Christ. Acting on behalf of Jesus Christ doesn't exclude Jesus himself, because he promised to be with us to the end of the world. We are called to act on behalf of Jesus Christ. So the act, the call is divine. And it is not a wise thing to try to do something divine by just human skill, wisdom, and other things. He trained them very well. But he says, still you need divine power to act on behalf of divine. I hope you remember that after the apostles were filled with the Holy Spirit, they started preaching the gospel, the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And the first one who started the preaching was Peter. And just after a few minutes of preaching, he won about 3,000 people for Christ. I guess you know very well how it is difficult to win a person for Christ, but he won 3,000 people for Christ. Especially in this advanced world, the Western. I have been in Europe for some years. I know the Western culture to some extent. I don't claim that I know a lot of things, but I know some. And I am just in America. This is my fourth day. I don't know about American culture, but I know a little bit about Western culture. And it's very difficult to win a person for Christ. Just a person. But when the Holy Spirit came upon Peter, the one who was not educated in the worldly system, but trained by Jesus Christ, because of the power that has come on Peter, he could act on behalf of Christ, and he won 3,000 people for Christ. As Pastor Glenn said, we have about 800,000 plus people, members of church in Ethiopia, just that is for Messiah Christos Church. There are a lot of denominations in Ethiopia with a lot of people in their congregation and their denomination. The work we are called for to do is divine. I would like to remind you of Matthew chapter 10, verses 7 and 8, where Christ commanded his apostles, go and preach the kingdom of God, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons, and raise dead. That was a commandment Jesus Christ gave to his apostles. This is obviously divine work they called for to do. This is all divine work. We can't do by ourselves. There is no way to raise dead or cast out demons, cleanse lepers, and other things just by our own. That's not possible. But what is not possible for man is possible for God. That is written in the gospel, right? How can we do that? When the Holy Spirit comes upon us, it makes a difference. It enables us to do what is not possible for us, but possible for God. I told you about my brother, my friend, in fact. It's a normal thing for me to just preach wherever people gather. So that time I was preaching, I did not know that he was in that particular bus, but I was preaching in the bus. That is normal in our country. That is no problem about that. I don't know if that is possible. I don't know if I am going to try that. But that is okay. That's what I have been doing. Wherever possible, I do that. But finally, my friend decided to follow Christ. Now he is leading a congregation, local church. My daughter, the oldest one, she graduated from university in March. She was filled with the Holy Spirit when she was just 8. And started speaking in tongue. I don't know if you believe. I'm not teaching doctrine or something else, but I am telling you just the experience I and my daughter have. And it is a normal thing for her to bear witness to Christ, like he died for the sinners and he resurrected from dead. That is what she does. That is a normal thing for her to do. Jesus says, when the Holy Spirit come upon you, you receive the power of the Holy Spirit. And it is also natural to bear witness to Christ that he died for sinners and resurrected from dead. That's a normal thing. You don't need to encourage or something like, but once a person is filled with the Holy Spirit, it's natural for that person to go out and bear witness to Christ. Brothers and sisters, we need the power of the Holy Spirit. Or in another way, I would like to say, we need to continue to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. Yeah? Yeah? We need to continue to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit so that we can win others for Christ. There are a lot of things that matter, but the power of the Holy Spirit matters a lot. I think you enjoy your Christianity, like you are in Christ, and you enjoy the peace you have, and a lot of things, the blessings that you got because you are in Christ. And there are others outside, a lot of them, waiting for this peace. There are a lot who are outside. And we need to bear witness to them that Jesus Christ loves them and he died and resurrected for their sin. Brothers and sisters, I have a lot of experience. After I received the Holy Spirit, I would say after I filled with the Holy Spirit, I have a lot of experience that I have seen in my ministry. When we are filled by the Holy Spirit, it's the Holy Spirit that works in us. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we stand for prayer? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You called us into your ministry, to continue your ministry, so that we would be blessing for others. Vela deme shepa parasia kopa dabayan samando shepa tarasia leba. Bariaka fala dusa nishta haviane somahaki arusei. Beyansanki avulaha dima ishia noviane korostola vedeano sapiene. Akaviana sora di mantola finia serash. Veanasu alla beanese. Kiboloshina trobuia sabia ficorane, sabuhu da fianistae. De viane kobahi filenti ano saraha difani. Hallelujah. Jimahadu yesama. Bikeria no luzivihinia mokoria shedian velesinia tu bivia. Velefando sa prokovala dia mashurian salvovondia salevenia. Let us continue to rely on the guardian, on the work of the Holy Spirit, so that we would win others for Christ. Ikalaviane saribohitel vihenista imasolaviane tipashia venias. Laviana, we are called to do divine work. Divine work with divine power. The power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We all know that the apostles, they were so successful in their ministry. The reason behind was they rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. They knew that their job, their work, their act was meant to be done by the power of the Holy Spirit. It was divine by divine power. Ivelitorica valia moturia shia pafilentonia sapai vicarian sapatiava. La mandosha ki avrasti, labia vina sukra vina nahi, tremigeni valadi. Vela prisalviti capilo vendia no shima hadive queso la bahivia. Iboria vela seto vacaria, shipavlandos in parivecenia lobedi. Hallelujah! Veli daviane, Jesus is alive and he is Lord. He is the one who saves. Kalivanta mayosebeve. Veliana, he is the one who loves us and he is the one who loves others outside of this congregation. Valikom falia demesha pivilikore sota vaya sabihivi. Laviriyan sapu vekialu findahantum vini sopavega. Laviriya lo shibaha vikesian alabhani. Valia, I pray for the blessing of my brothers and sisters. They would be blessed by the work of the Holy Spirit, so that we be guided by the Holy Spirit and win others for Christ. Valitakiana you lashi pivilito kavendo sapivilere kandale binivi. I pray, Lord Jesus, so that the Holy Spirit would work among my brothers and sisters. Zafikia, so they have such a strong unity.
Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Bage falo deina, lusciata crasia videli comande zivitia. Lomanto pivil, keri zalfristal verkenia lomandia so. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. 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 Shatenno saia. Awaki solavindo. Hallelujah.
The power of the Holy Spirit for a life surrendered that's expressed in effectively winning people to walk alongside of us for Jesus, winning people for Christ. And so I want to ask Pastor Gishu to pray over us specifically for that this morning. And so if you'd like to have that special anointing of the Holy Spirit to be especially manifest in your life in proclaiming the gospel, would you just come forward? And then we'll have Pastor Gishu especially lay on hands and pray for us, okay? Okay? So we'll just stay down here on the floor, okay? And we'll just, so please come forward. Please respond.
Oh, hallelujah. O minati komai asia bukaya mai sola habivanda tulobeishihi. Auga hadima hadima lusabi faliande doria shala hadia. O papashia kravadia sena. Lavani korosjo totorasi glevahadia moyene mantorra bashi. Do paparia sopele veni krabashulla hamana mai yaso bahadiva. Brakato mai asi blahevini kreshulla hadino lashemahadia. Baio samati pipirian sakia vali teni torrashe plevenka sopaya mase. Veli kambora itali shapaya mai stakia vala me andoma hiasia. Bekomanai eta bivili korai shadi la fapira kasana mantola vanvaria satia de losha. Hallelujah, mai kankalia sopiela fino kovalte. Jolavia kubahishia la vina hakramasulia buponia senda. Jeven kora saita malavon doho rashia la babahakiava. Bela fatino samili vain komande li banto la geni vartiko la shabivi. Omado la hagia no si priveki la samahati vole genta. Repala kosina hal buntani vikla shapravadia le samatia. Hallelujah. Maka parra shebolan dal giontaria lo comande. Jabika virasa kialo mantel heval bura la katababaya. Blakuvania sapuhi dal fin tarisho da hamani. Bagendo la simahaduba la sabahaje verikam balo in tania. La manturi vije sabuhul gendal virakam ba tulaha gemando la vi. Padori salahati alomahandi. Gambahadula shina hola bida. Hallelujah. Makialo simarte vi kala sonda baha geneva. Bigaria salaha vi kondo la venarihi balahdi ma shihado. Jamokaria sobahati vakia rosa bahaltene varolamanda. Joholamandi la povar kiamala bihile vira solahati valata ramadi. Hallelujah. Mai korashi bahatole vene rasula. Bigariano la pintaru fazargian del mirvendo la gemando. Mandaliver kiasili ver jadila hatina vela. Bigoria solahati vel kottamaneri balovine. Radia lo shipofal keri samahal tuvenia. Jampa vel kias la vire sal vertako la veria sala. Hallelujah, hallelujah, mahaka le vere santaya. Hallelujah, resi la brihel vitania mai veni. Velika bujenia varkesal burvadandeia. Oia mai sheika li varia sukuvilidini. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Risolo vai deli corra sali canto alla ver jalia mania. Veli cavi allo satul verteni malovania so bai vid. Sacchiava la picori solo conto la barra. Le vita bia sulla vita mash che li virian solo vadi. Hallelujah, oh hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Jesus is alive, yes. Auba kifala suria levendo. Obokore filizar filtari valkeno shadi aleva. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.